Greetings, Cloud Gurus. I'm Tom Dean, and welcome to Linux This Month. In this episode, we're going to cover Rocky Linux 8.4's general availability, the newly released DarkRadiation Ransomware, Debian 10.10's arrival, the push to bring Rust to Linux kernel development, and we're saying goodbye to Groovy Gorilla. Let's take a look. Another viable alternative to CentOS has reached general availability. With the Rocky Enterprise Software Foundation's first GA release, Rocky Linux 8.4. Rocky Linux 8.4 is based on Red Hat Enterprise Linux 8.4, right down to the bugs. We'll find out more about Rocky Linux in our top stories. If you're running Ubuntu 20.10, listen up. 20.10, or Groovy Gorilla, was released back in October 2020, and support is about to end, with 20.10 reaching end of life on July 22nd, 2021. Those who are on 20.10 have been advised to update to 21.04, which is an actively supported release. Ubuntu 20.10 was the first Ubuntu release to support Raspberry Pi 4 and included Kernel 5.8, NF tables, GNOME 3.3.8, and more. We may be saying farewell to 2010, but we'll keep a special place in our heart right next to Slackware Linux. The 10th update of the 10th stable distribution of Debian, a.k.a. Buster, has arrived. This update brings 136 updated packages, 55 of which are security updates. Bug fixes include new versions of ClamAV, MariaDB, the NVIDIA graphics drivers, and the Linux kernel. Security fixes include Nginx, Bind9, Tomcat9, and Squid. Existing users can get the 0.10 goodness using the apt installer, while those who are starting from scratch can download a fresh copy from the Debian mirrors. Get it while it's hot. With the backing of Google and the Internet Security Research Group, as well as the blessing of Linus Torvalds, the call to bring Rust to the table for Linux kernel development is starting to look like a reality. It is believed that kernel development in Rust will help reduce the number of bugs, increasing the security and stability of Linux. We'll drill down a little deeper on the push to bring Rust to Linux kernel development in our top stories. Researchers have recently discovered a new ransomware variant, DarkRadiation, that appears to be under development. DarkRadiation, which is implemented in Bash, avoids many common malware detection methods. It targets mainly Red Hat and Debian-based distributions, going after Docker containers running on these hosts as well. We'll also take a deeper look at DarkRadiation in our top stories. On with it. There are a few big items I'd like to explore. Those are the push to bring Rust to Linux kernel development and the discovery of DarkRadiation. But first, let's meet Rocky Linux. Rocky Linux 8.4, aka Green Obsidian, has reached general availability, bringing more choice to users looking for a CentOS replacement. Gregory Kurtzer, co-creator of CentOS, announced the Rocky project back in December 2020. Shortly after Red Hat announced their decision to move the CentOS project upstream of Red Hat Enterprise Linux, leaving many large CentOS users without a long-term future for their install base. In addition, support for CentOS 8 is slated to end in 2021, adding to the sense of urgency for current users. Like CentOS before it, Rocky Linux is based on the Red Hat Enterprise Linux codebase, currently version 8.4, right down to the bugs, ensuring compatibility with corresponding RHEL releases, which made CentOS a perfect fit for many users for so many years. The Rocky Enterprise Software Foundation was also created to keep Rocky Linux independent and to build a community charter that will enable and protect users and the larger community. Alma Linux, another RHEL-based distribution that aims to fill the void left by CentOS moving upstream, is currently the other major alternative for users looking to migrate away from CentOS. Alma Linux parent company Cloud Linux was able to leverage their experience producing a security-hardened RHEL clone to get their CentOS replacement to market in short order. Welcome to GA, Rocky Linux. It's great to have choices. While the Linux kernel has historically been written in C, Google and the Internet Security Research Group, the folks who brought us Let's Encrypt, have joined a chorus of voices calling to bring Rust to Linux kernel development. Historically, C has been used for Linux kernel development, and with the quality of Linux kernel code and standards review, it's been relatively safe. Still, kernel code is not immune to memory safety bugs, and Rust offers most of what developers rely on with C, but it is believed that using Rust will reduce the number of bugs in the kernel, increasing the security and stability of Linux. Rust does this by implementing safe and unsafe Rust, where programmers can operate in safety unless they need to perform an unsafe operation where they will declare this to the compiler. This results in safer code on the whole. Proponents for Rust adoption aren't calling for a top-down rewrite, but to allow new code to be written using Rust so that future memory safety bugs will trend downward as more new code is introduced. A great example of this would be device driver development. As kernel development progresses, more of the kernel could be moved to Rust, enhancing memory safety. Due to the widespread adoption of Linux, anything that can be done to enhance kernel security is a big deal, hence the heavyweight backing. Even the man himself, Linus Torvalds, is on board with inviting Rust to the party. Here's to a very rusty kernel in the future. A new ransomware variant, DarkRadiation, which avoids many common detection methods, has grabbed the attention of malware researchers. Favoring Red Hat and Debian-based distributions, DarkRadiation also targets Docker containers running on these hosts as well, which should give enterprises a moment of pause. DarkRadiation, which is implemented in Bash, not only uses OpenSSL to encrypt files, but leverages the Telegram messaging service for command and control communications. The malware hides itself in places that most administrators aren't keeping a close eye on, like directories for man pages. In addition, there are mechanisms for obfuscating the bash scripts by breaking them up into chunks so they can be reassembled later to be executed. So far, there haven't been any reports of real-world attacks using DarkRadiation, with the consensus of researchers being that the malware is still under development. But those operating Linux systems should be vigilant, as the potential for damage is there, with researchers still unfolding the puzzle of DarkRadiation. Check your systems and be safe out there. That's it for this episode of Linux This Month. If you like the show, be sure to smash that thumbs up button and make sure you stay on top of the latest Linux news by subscribing. Have a question? Feel free to ask in the comments. May your source remain open and your code compile cleanly. See you next time, and remember to keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.